to do to start off with is I'm going to get two of the home team, Bridges Ventures team, to kick off. Two co-founders of Bridges. They've been around the whole 10 years. You wouldn't believe it from how old they look. Phillip Newborough, the managing partner, and then Michelle Giddens. And what they're going to do is set out where and why Bridges has got this event organized tonight, and they'll show a quick six-minute film, setting out what they think is the practical contribution Bridges can make to this issue of combining impact, social impact, with commercial return. So let's start with Phillip. Phillip, thank you.
Good evening, and a very warm welcome to you all. We at Bridges are truly delighted that you are here this evening to mark our 10th anniversary. With your help this evening, we want to not only look back over the last 10 years, but more importantly, look forward to the next decade. But just for a moment, I'd just like to look back. Bridges was founded in 2002 with support from Apex Partners, 3i and Tom Singh. We have since grown from our first small £40 million fund to now almost £300 million under management across our sustainable growth funds, our property funds, and our social entrepreneurs fund. 10 years ago, many people thought that deliberately investing to achieve positive social outcomes would inevitably lead to poor financial returns. I think the main thing we have learned and demonstrated over the past 10 years is that excellent financial returns and impact can go hand in hand. So many of you in this room have been part of our journey. First of all, I'm so happy to see many of the investors in our funds here tonight. You're all pioneers and have shown great leadership. We simply cannot thank you enough for your trust and for being so supportive. The entrepreneurs and management teams that we've worked with have clearly been a very big part of our journey. And I want to give you just three facts. Firstly, more than 90% of our businesses are based in the most deprived 25% of this country. And more than half of them are in the poorest 10%. Secondly, between them, they've already saved more than enough energy to power the whole city of Derby for the next 12 months. And thirdly, in what has been an awful climate for small business, really, over recent years, between them, on average, over the past year, they've achieved a growth of 20%, on average, between them. Our investment approach has also attracted incredible human capital, right through our board, our advisory board, and, of course, the Bridges team. Thanks very much to my partners, who are all here this evening, and to all of the team at Bridges for your fantastic contribution. However, my short comments this evening would not be complete without me making two very special mentions. First, Nigel Doughty, who so sadly passed away suddenly on the 4th of February this year. As you may know, Nigel was one of the very early supporters of Bridges. He served on our board. He was a very generous philanthropist and a good friend. His firm, Doughty Hanson, and his family trust have been enormously supportive of our work. Our thoughts are, of course, with his wife, Lucy, and his children. He's already badly missed. And so finally, to our founding chairman, Sir Ronald Cohen. This evening also marks Ronald's transition to chair of our advisory board, and the appointment of Peter Englander as our new chair. Peter, we look forward to working even more closely with you over the coming years. Through the work of the Social Investment Task Force in 2000, Ronald developed a vision for a thriving social investment sector. Being Ronald, however, the vision wasn't enough. He financed, used his energy, and put his reputation on the line to help Michelle and I get Bridges off the ground in 2002 and begin to make that vision a reality. It's a running joke that over the years, so many things seem to have been incubated in Ronald's basement. Peter Englander will tell you very clearly how the original Apex Ventures team was founded in a tiny basement in Upper Brook Street. And more recently, social finance and big society capital have been incubated in the basement of Ron's current office at Portland Place. Personally, I served my apprenticeship in the late 1980s at Apex in a small cupboard office at the end of the corridor next to the toilet. But when we started Bridges, Michelle and I thought we were really lucky and super special, because Ronald offered us the use of a whole floor at Apex Partners, just the two of us. What he didn't tell us is that the floor had been completely stripped of everything, ceiling, lighting, carpet tiles, the lot. The only thing that was left was sort of glue on the floor where the carpet tiles had been. That was like treacle as you walked through it. But anyway, back to Ronald. Ronald, you've been a constant inspiration to us over the past 10 years, and to me personally over the last 25. Bridges would not exist without you. And as you transition to chair of our advisory board, we are so grateful for your continued support and guidance. Thank you very much. So as much as I might like to stand here and tell you so much more about our funds, businesses, teams and entrepreneurs, we thought instead we'd make a short film so that they can tell you in their own words. I really hope you enjoy the evening. Thank you very much.